Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can listen for and fire events within Node.js. So real quick before we start, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the warrantoffkeys Discord. If you post in either of those two places, I'm sure someone will be able to help you out. So starting things off, I have this empty index file, and we are going to import the events package, which is installed with Node.js by default, so you do not have to install it manually. I'm going to say constant EventEmitter, and both of these are going to be capitalized, symbolizing that this is a class. This is going to equal require events. Now we have to actually create an instance or an object from this class. We could say constant emitter equals new EventEmitter. And now we can actually use this to listen for and fire events. So for example, if I want to listen for a custom event, such as something called user join, I can do it with emitter.on. Then here's the actual name of the event as a string. I can say user join, and then we're going to have a callback here, and this function will be ran whenever this event is fired. Now to actually fire this event, I can say emitter.emit, and then we can pass in the actual name of the event. So I can say user join. And now if I were to run this, nothing would actually happen because within our callback, we're not actually doing anything. So I can add a simple console log saying event fired. I can then save this and I can run this code with node index.js, and we then see event fired. Now, if I were to comment this out here and I were to run the code again, nothing actually happens because the event is actually never fired. Also keep in mind that if you are listening for the event after we are actually firing the event, then nothing will actually happen because whenever this line is ran, it's going to look for existing listeners. So it's important that you listen for the events before you actually fire them. Now I'm going to show you how you can pass in information. So let's say hypothetically we had some object here and we can say user is Joe and then their email is test@test.com. So this object is actually going to be passed in as an argument to this function. So we have access to user. I can then console log the user here. I can save this and I can run the code. We then see event fired and then we see our object right here, which is the object that was fired from right here. So next I want to explain a warning that some of you might have run into when actually listening for events. If I were to take this event listener, and I'm going to put this inside of a for loop, so let a equals 0 while a is less than 20, plus plus a, this will just loop through 20 times. So we're going to listen for this 20 times. If I save this and I run the code, we get our user printed 20 times, but also we see max listeners exceeded warning. Possible event emitter memory leak detected, 11 user join listeners added to event emitter. And so this is going to be a problem because if you have more than 10 event listeners for this specific event, it's going to throw this warning. Now your code is still going to work as expected as we see up here, but we want to try and fix this. Obviously the proper fix here is to not put this inside of a for loop and to try and minimize the amount of event listeners that you have. However, if this is not possible for your application for whatever reason, then you can actually edit this. So you can say event emitter dot default max listeners equals some higher number. Let's say 50, for example. I can then save this and I can run the code again and we no longer get the warning. However, this is not the proper way to fix this. It is important that you actually just fix the initial problem, such as removing it from the for loop or whatever your use case might be. Now, a couple quick notes for those of you who are following my Discord JS series. When it comes to the advanced command handler, the best way to solve this is to actually format your code to use the commando framework, which I've recently released a video on. Also, you might be familiar with some of the syntax when it comes to the .on, some string, and then a function. That's because Discord JS actually uses events. If I go to the Discord JS documentation and I scroll down to client, which you often use as your actual client, some of you might name it bot, it's the same thing. We can then scroll up and we see client extends base client. If we click on this, we then see base client extends event emitter, which is the exact thing that we are using here. So this is why the syntax seems similar if you've used this within certain APIs, is because it is Node's event system and it's fairly simple to actually implement within your own applications. And so this is a basic rundown of how you're going to use the event system within Node.js. If you found this video helpful, then please consider liking and subscribing. And again, if you need help with anything, consider joining the Warrantoffkeys Discord server. A link to that can be found in the video description. Thanks for watching.